This review was made possible by contributions from viewers like you.
Hey guys, and welcome back to Bob Shoween. No Halloween season would be complete without a little werewolf hijinks, which is why today we're going to be looking at 100% Wolf. And in case you're wondering, yes, the pink fro wig will make sense later on.
Why is your pink fro wig less shocking than your lack of a beard?
Oh, get over it already.
No, I don't do change.
And speaking of... There we go. Time for you to get into costume as well.
Okay. This kind of change I can deal with.
Our movie begins in a little town in the Pacific Northwestern region of Australia, where some werewolves indulging in a little parkour are running into a building that's on fire because they're superheroes?
Does Australia just not have firefighters? Why is it up to the werewolves who shouldn't exist?
Thank God they saved the title.
Nope, just went up in smoke.
They're followed by this little kid named Freddy, who... Wait, what the... Why does that license plate just have a little ham icon on it?
Eh, it's Australia. Don't question it.
Anyway, this Freddy kid is a part of this werewolf pack, since werewolves come in packs just like regular wolves, I guess. And he's excited to play superheroes with them, despite still being just a pup who hasn't grown into his fur yet. Apparently, he was able to follow them with the aid of this ring called the Moonstone.
You imbecile! If that falls into the wrong hands...
Easy. He's just young and eager.
Young and reckless. The boy needs disciplining pleasure.
Maybe he needs some discipline, but please don't give him any pleasure. Actually, what he's saying is he needs disciplining Flashheart. Flashheart being the name of Freddy's father here. But he says it so quickly that Raven and I must have spent 10 minutes playing this scene over and over again to hear what he actually said, because there's no way he could have said the boy needs pleasure. I hope. Speaking of names, Flashheart here is accompanied by Lady Hightail, insert your own dirty joke here, and this other wolf is his brother, Hotspur, but with the Australian accents flying around, it sounds like everyone's calling him Chutzpah. And the red fur makes him look Scottish, so we have Australian, Scottish, Jewish Uncle Chutzpah. Instead of doing the sensible thing and sending Freddy home, they let him tag along while they keep the city from falling apart, because everyone in this town is completely helpless. It also goes without saying that Freddy's involvement leads to Uncle Chutzpah's repeated humiliation on top of his already feeling resentful of living in Flashheart's shadow, so... yeah. It's like The Lion King, except Simba is just awful and makes us want Uncle Scar to kill him. Flashheart finally takes the little interloper home, running through Disney's California Adventure in the process, when they almost run into... Bowler Hat Guy from Meet the Robinsons, I guess, driving an ice cream truck in the dead of night. Maybe he's the cousin of that guy from Justice League War. Then again, at least that guy was selling ice cream at the National Mall, where someone might buy some ice cream, despite what time of day it is. Why is this guy in the middle of the forest?
Did you just see that, Scoops? Was that a wolf abducting a little boy? Oh, someone needs to save him! What? Stop staring at me! Why should I go after him? Stop staring at me! Stop staring!
Son of a bitch, movie. You've already got me rooting for evil Uncle Chutzpah. Now you want me to cheer on this guy, too?
Dad, why are we hiding from some ice cream guy?
Humans don't get us, Freddy. And what they don't understand
They destroy you.
I scream bowler hat guy follows them, as they make their way back towards that giant wolf rock they passed earlier. Let me get this bit of bullcrap.
It's the moon spirits that decide what kind of wolves we become.
Are the great kings of the past up there too?
I want massive fangs
and night vision,
and I want to be big. Yeah, like huge big. And
I think they got the message. Listen, now the best wolves don't have the sharpest claws or the pointiest teeth.
Don't you fucking dare.
They have the biggest hearts.
I'm sorry, didn't you just say that you're hiding from mankind who would otherwise destroy you since they don't understand you? Seems to me like sharp claws and pointy teeth would be better at defending yourself than giving your attacker a hug. And what about the all-too-important task of hunting? Are you able to bring your pack more marsupial caribou by asking them nicely to come along with you?
Wish Mom was still here.
Oh, and his mom's dead. Of course she is. Sorry, kid. It's not enough to make me suddenly start liking you. Ice Cream Bowler Hat Guy catches up with them and falls off the rock like a dumbass, and Flash Heart falls over the edge as well, trying to save him. Oh no, he's dead. I'm sure he won't be totally fine by the end of the movie somehow. Ice Cream Bowler Hat Guy manages to save himself in time to see Freddy being dragged out by Uncle Chutzpah. Then we cut to the house from Daddy I'm a Zombie, where the rest of the pack are mourning Flash Heart's totally real passing. What is that? Is someone singing through a saxophone? And fine, they're werewolves, and they're sad because of the death of their leader. But they're human right now. Why are they howling? Do they all drink out of the toilet, too? 6 years later, it's time for Freddy to officially become the pack's high howler, despite him still being dangerously clumsy. And he's called downstairs to the initiation by...
Oh, hey! Mrs. Mutton.
Mrs. Mutton? Is she a were-sheep? Actually, she's just a regular human. Yeah. This family of werewolves who is trying to hide from humanity hired a regular human as the maid. I guess they're not worried about her exposing them to the world because they all have really big hearts, right? Meanwhile, Uncle Chutzpah is making the case to Lord and Lady Hightail, who are aristocratic and clearly of some high standing in their pack, but they somehow aren't the pack leaders themselves, that he should be the high howler because of his success in ridding the town of stray dogs. But they turn him down because of his inability to get the moonstone back from Ice Cream Bowler Hat Guy. Can't say that I blame them. What kind of wolf can't take this guy out? Okay, so he has tranquilizers and silver dust balls that put wolves to sleep, since that's how silver works. But what's stopping these guys from looking for the moonstone as humans? Freddy joins the rest of his wolfy family and turns into a werewolf for the first time.
Step into the light.
I'm ready for this.
I wasn't ready for that.
Say hello to the big bad wolf.
What is this?
It's called a snack. Go nuts.
The boy is cursed because he lost the moonstone ring.
No.
The moon spirits are punishing us.
What?
Once we were feared beasts. Look at us hiding in the shadows. And now we're to be led by a dog.
No, but I am a real wolf.
Freddy. You bring shame on the memory of your father.
No. Well, that's what you get for naming him Freddy. Let's look at these other wolves. Flashheart, Hightail, Chutzpah, Freddy. Couple that with how nobody taught him how to be a proper wolf, you raised him to be a joke.
Collect them all! Fightgar, Krakotage, Silent Rip, Firebird, Gunhaver, Flash Fight, Ripburger, Foxface, Reinforcements, and Reynold! Then take the action even further with Reynold's Apartment Extreme playset!
Ugh, I really need to go grocery shopping! I wish my girlfriend didn't leave me!
You have until moonrise tomorrow to prove you are a real wolf. Otherwise, the moon spirits will choose a new High Howler, and you will be banished.
Or you could rework your system of government so it doesn't rely on arbitrary natural forces, which I guess had a sense of humor. And moonrise tomorrow? Last time I checked, the full moon happens every month, not every night. Freddy's bratty little cousins get their mitts on him and give him a makeover.
Look at yourself! No, no!
See? I told you the pink hair would make sense.
Look! Solid silver! That'll stop you from morphing back into a boy.
No? Shouldn't it just make you sleepy?
And what's stopping him from getting Mrs. Mutton to take it off?
But he gets away from them and they get locked in the attic.
It's okay. I'll just post an SOS to my followers. There's no reception?
Of course there's no reception. A pack of werewolves who's trying to remain underground wouldn't have Wi-Fi! And why is your first instinct upon finding yourself in a fix to call for help from your social media followers you aren't supposed to have? Did you just forget that you have this really huge family downstairs?
How much worse can it get?
We're only 23 minutes into this piece of crap. There's plenty of room for it to get worse. He briefly considers asking Mrs. Mutton for help.
Mrs. Mutton?
But because that makes too much sense, he immediately forgets about it and begins his quest for the Moonstone without any idea of where to start looking.
Ah! Yow! Ow! Oh.
Huh? Okay, what the hell kind of world is this? I thought maybe this ice cream guy being out this late was just a fluke, but we've got pizza guys casually walking their pizzas to their customers, hot dog vendors, and now freak traffic from out of nowhere? Did everyone just forget about sleep? Why is everything still open? Is this just a city full of vampires and that's what the werewolves are hiding from? Of course it isn't, because that might actually be kinda cool! Sadly, Freddy gets saved from this other doggy named Batty. Oh hi, Aretha from the Hugo movies, how's your sex life? Don't answer that! Freddy tries to convince Batty that he's really a human, while making sure that we see this toupee or not toupee shop because it's going to be part of a big reveal that'll be about as rewarding as a 1 cent tip. And he asks for her help to look for the Moonstone.
I've got meat.
I'm listening.
Oh dear.
Nice pickup line.
They strike a bargain, but they're interrupted by these embarrassingly incompetent dog catchers. Yes, yes, but does she give a damn about her bad reputation? Yeah, remind me again how Uncle Chutzpah made a name for himself in this business when he has idiots like this in his employ? And for that matter, why are werewolves even afraid of humans? If this little nothing can take down two of them single-pawedly, I'm pretty sure the werewolves can handle themselves. Since the movie needs to pad things out, we get a little montage of Batty teaching Freddy how to be a proper dog, including how to sniff out a pee trail. Lovely.
I guess this city only has male dogs?
Yep, that warrants this tender, we're becoming fast friends music.
I'm leading the way. And I thought the point of this montage was to teach Freddy how to be a dog. Why is Batty pointing with her fingers like a human?
I love you.
I know.
The montage finally comes to an end when they casually spot some of Freddy's family in passing. Sure is a good thing that the humans just actively ignore them.
Okay, Freddy. Last lesson. Werewolves are evil.
What? Says who?
Says everyone! That's why your family is hiding from them, you idiot!
Werewolves run around at night pretending to help people, but they're really scared.
stone-cold psychos who sacrifice puppies to their moon god.
And yet again, I'm feeling like we're missing out on this much better movie.
They drink blood at night and sleep in freaky coffins during the day.
That's not true. I don't know where you're getting your information from, but werewolves are...
Why are you defending them?
Because you're clearly getting werewolves confused with vampires. And I'm sorry, but how did these werewolves get any kind of monstrous reputation? Nobody sleeps in this town, and for all the good that these wolves do, someone would have spotted them doing it by now. These wolves aren't the bestial monsters that traditional werewolf lore describes them as. They may not be able to talk back to you when they're in wolf form, but they're intelligent! They can be reasoned with! There is no reason for anyone to be afraid of these things! They pass a poster advertising the imminent opening of another toupee or not toupee store. Because remember, this is really important! Then they come across Ice Cream Bowler Hat Guy's Wolf Museum, which is somehow still open for business despite not getting any business. But then Freddy gets captured by him.
You know why I got into ice cream? For the friends! Everyone loves the ice cream man, right? Wrong! It's the delicious cones they come for! Not me. No one ever asks Foxwell Crip about his day. The night I saw that boy get eaten, I figured, finally, people would start paying attention to me.
No one got eaten! I am that boy!
I tried to warn them, but they wouldn't listen, would they? No! They called me Flakehead and Cuckoo Crip and Foxwell Farty Poopscoop!
Have you tried talking to adults? After running a few tests, because an ice cream man off his rocker with no means of financial funding can totally do that, Patty springs Freddy and they escape with the Moonstone.
Don't you judge me! Where were you?
Huh? Wait a minute. I've seen that crest before. Lupin.
Are you serious?! This family of werewolves is named Lupin? And everyone in town knows them! You're obsessed with finding werewolves, and you don't think of going to the Lupins as the first place to look? And for that matter, where did these kids even get this silver collar in the first place? Isn't this a really dangerous item for these werewolves to have? It's not like they're even keeping it for security purposes like Superman hanging onto Lex Luthor's kryptonite ring. It was stolen by a couple of kids! Why would they make these things themselves and then put their family crest on it? But again, how does someone this obsessed with wolves not think to investigate the Lupins?
He talks to a stuffed monkey. Let's cut him some slack.
I suppose in-universe stupidity is somewhat more tolerable than filmmakers with no sense stupidity.
Exactly.
Freddy and Batty have a fight for no reason that'll just be resolved in a minute, because movies like this always have the main characters fight for no reason just to have it be resolved in a minute. And Freddy learns that this stray doesn't exactly live in the best conditions. Oh my god, what a twist.
Don't feel bad. It's not the first time I've been ditched.
Movie, if I wanted to watch Bolt, trust me, I would just watch Bolt.
They leave her. Wondering what she did wrong.
They make up just in time for the dog catchers to sneak up on them somehow.
They must have been undercover of plot convenience.
Then they're taken to the pound. Uncle Chutzpah shows up and takes the Moonstone from Freddy, and instead of just killing him right here and now, he instead tosses Freddy into the kennel with Batty and some other dogs we don't care about.
He left me!
How is your uncle a werewolf?
How do you know he's a werewolf?
I was supposed to be a werewolf, but this, not some fluffy pink joke.
Oh my gosh, it all makes sense. I knew you smelled funny. That's why you acted so weird.
And yet you didn't believe him when he tried to tell you that he's a boy. This is on you, dumbass.
You lied to me. I trusted you. Maybe that's why your family doesn't want you, because you hurt them.
No, they don't want him because he's a poodle. He's a failure at everything that he does. He is so much of a joke that even his younger cousins laugh at him. They don't want him because he is nothing. This is just adorable. This movie's trying so hard to have a dramatic moment, but it's done nothing to get us here. Your family doesn't want you because you hurt people. Give me a fucking break. A guard comes by sometime later to give them some food, giving Batty an idea. In all the time it took you to do that, you could have run under the door, found yourself a job, bought yourself a house, and written your memoirs. But this little plan quickly goes south, attracting the attention of this woman calling herself the Commander, whose animation should be very stiff and reserved, but no, make her as rubbery and wacky as everyone else in this movie, because it's not like how a character moves is important or anything. Then we get this delightful bit of, "Oh no you didn't!"
Try it, squeaky toy.
Bruno, no! It's not a sprinkler!
I feel it!
Freddy, help!
Thank you, movie. We needed to drag out this stupid pee joke into a bigger deal than it needed to be, and whatever menace could be wrought out of this lady has been completely destroyed.
Try it, squeaky toy.
That should have ended with her snapping his little doggy neck. After that sample of highfalutin humor, they toss Freddy into this dungeon beneath the pound so he can be eaten by the beast. Oh god, no, not that one! Before we can see Freddy meet his well-deserved fate, we jump over to Mrs. Mutton, who somehow deduces that he's at the pound, so she heads off to find him. Mrs. Mutton is part of a biker gang called the Angry Rams? She is a were-sheep! I remember not so long ago when every movie grandma wasn't a biker. It's just not funny anymore, guys. But if you have to go down this route and you have to make her part of a biker gang called the Angry Rams, the least you could do is stick some ram horns on her helmet! Why is she dressed like that little dinosaur from Bubble Bobble?
Okay, fine! Do it! Eat me! Just make it quick!
Yuck. Huh? I don't eat dog.
Then what the hell have you been living on for the past 6 years?! It's OMG, the beast is actually Fleshheart, who's totally not dead. Wow, who saw that coming?
Oh, Dad!
No! But
you!
My Freddy is 100% wolf!
Please shut up. Repeating a stupid title doesn't make it any less stupid. We then get a little flashback showing that he somehow survived, and he was taken to the Dog Pound's dungeon.
You had your turn, brother. It's mine now.
Huh? Silver?
Just in case.
What?! Why would Uncle Hutzpah want his brother to remain a wolf?! Aren't these werewolves super strong?! Good idea locking him up while he's injured and weak, in this dungeon which will never be explained, but why would you keep him as a wolf?! He's gonna get better! He's gonna get strong again! What is the point of keeping him super strong?! Why don't you just kill him?!
So, you're a poodle now.
Yeah, I'm a poodle. I'm sorry. I know it's not what you wanted.
What are you apologizing for? It's not like he wanted you to be a wolf.
But, you know what? Dogs are actually the kindest, most thoughtful creatures I ever met.
Let's go, Pinky!
Poodle.
You better run along before you get hurt, poodle.
What did you call me? You want a piece of me? Huh?
So, I've been thinking.
That must have hurt.
Beat it, Pinky.
Wow. Excellent story.
What did he do? Break your hair, girlie?
I've got meat.
I'm listening. Why should I trust you? You need to start acting like a real dog, or I'm not taking you anywhere. Last chance, poodle. Are you some kind of wolf lover or something?
Good luck. What? Deal was, I get you to crib, you give me meat.
Thanks, partner.
I wouldn't go that far. Why don't you be a pal and take me to the meat?
That makes me mad.
I will end you! I don't need your help.
Clearly. Then the other dogs get into the dungeon by way of the ventilation system, because of course animals with no thumbs can open up air vents. And then they proceed to beat the crap out of this massive, super-strong werewolf because...
Physics! Physics! Physics!
Freddy gets them to stop fighting because I guess he's strong enough to do so. Then the dogs tell them about something they saw on their way into the dungeon.
Run final tests. In ugly. Out fabulous!
We've got to get out of here. The commander's built some machine to turn us into weird fern nests to go on human heads!
Fern nests? When the time comes, all you have to do is press this button.
Excellent.
Wigs! They're gonna turn us into wigs!
Yeah, flashing back to that wig store imagery sure was important. It's not like we could figure that out just by that little graphic that they showed us.
Guys, let's help him!
Sure.
Well, that was embarrassingly easy. Our werewolf, ladies and gentlemen! Speaking of embarrassing, they make their way into the sewers when Mrs. Mutton shows up.
And who do you think you are? I'm the housekeeper.
And she's more of a badass than the fucking werewolf. Does anyone see anything wrong with this picture?
Australian Ninja Housekeeper.
Freddy!
Master Flytrot!
She didn't even know they were there! She just happened to show up right where they were? What the hell? So the little old lady beats up three people half her age while the giant hulking werewolf does nothing, and they all get away.
So what's the plan?
We kick Uncle Hotspur's butt!
After that, you get the magic rock and turn into a wolf?
Something like that.
Too bad. The poodle was growing on me.
Then through sheer idiocy, the idiot wolf and all of his idiot friends died. The end. No, actually, they come out into the subway. Because the subway's always holding hands with the sewers. Or was this just the labyrinthine catacombs of the Dog Pound's dungeon? Or... this movie sucks!
We did it!
What is wrong with you?
How much time do you have? It turns out these tiny beams of sunlight are turning him back into a human, and the dogs are disgusted by his nudity for some reason.
Oh, whoa! Sweet mother of pups!
That is not okay.
Wieners! Get your wieners!
Happens to the best of us, son.
Why didn't you change?
This.
You were simplistically designed so that your forearm is just a long cone, and you don't have a wrist. What's stopping you from just pulling that thing off? And why is Freddy's hair still pink? His dog hair is not the same thing as his human hair. These werewolves don't transform, they just magically poof out of existence and then poof back into existence in a different body. If his hair is still pink, so should his ears be, except they aren't. We also don't see the werewolves tearing through their clothing like other werewolves do when they transform. Their clothes just poof away with the rest of their humanity, leaving me to think that transforming back into people would bring their clothes back with them, so this whole Naked Freddy thing isn't only uncomfortable, but it makes no frickin' sense either.
And this is taking place at sundown, right?
I don't think this is sunrise, no.
So we're only minutes away from him becoming a real wolf because big heart, blah blah blah. So the Naked Freddy was uncomfortable, nonsensical, and also completely pointless.
Let's go.
We'll find you some clothes on the way.
No, you're 80 pounds. You're not hopping this fence. Freddy grabs some spare clothes while they sneak back to their house, while Uncle Chutzpah is about to be dubbed the new pack leader.
Order! Order! For the first time in history, this pack finds itself without a high howler.
Why not? It's been 6 years! Chutzpah announces his master plan of creating a dog-free world by turning a handful of dogs into wigs, but then he's interrupted by Freddy, who might as well be wearing a suit made of kick-me signs. But then Ice Cream Bowler Hat Guy shows up and begins shooting all the wolves with silver powder balls from a machine gun that looks like a giant ice cream cone.
Welcome to your new life as exhibits in my wolf aquarium!
Stop it!
What are you doing in here, boy? Get out of it! You're the boy! But you got eaten! I'm avenging you against these beasts!
He's insane. He's completely alone. He operates out of a misplaced sense of justice. He's a slave to his own particular gimmick. Why the hell isn't this guy a Batman villain? He needs to be a Batman villain! Freddy grabs Chutzpah's remote and they have a little chase all over the house that's about as tense as a wet paper bag. They get up to the roof and Freddy finds his place in the moonlight. Eat him. And you still have the pink hair, huh? What, did the moon spirits decide that you shall forever be marked as an impotent little bitch who's easily tormented by your cousins? Sure, be proud of that, why not?
A poodle?
No, a were-poodle.
Tell us that we're all special in our own unique ways, even if our own unique ways might seem detrimental according to traditional wisdom? Fine! Do that! Part of the appeal of Bumblebee from the original Transformers cartoon was that he was the smallest of the Autobots, and it allowed him to go into smaller places where a heavy hitter like Optimus Prime could not. If you want to tell us that Freddy somehow found value in being a poodle, despite not having any reason for doing so, that's fine! Do that! But you don't do it by giving him a supersonic roar! That's fucking stupid, and everyone involved in bringing this scene to life should be fucking ashamed of themselves! Ugh, so all's well that ends well as the Dog Pound staff are arrested. Uncle Chutzpah is not disowned by the family, nor arrested for his involvement with the Dog Pound. The dogs all get to live with the werewolves, who I guess just forgot about hating and fearing them. Everybody decides that they actually like Ice Cream Bowler Hat Guy from out of nowhere. And while Freddy is fine not being the high howler of his pack since his dad is still alive to keep the title for himself, he's still leading the charge in their superheroing exploits, and I'm sure Daddy's still doing nothing in terms of guiding him or raising him to be the future leader, so he might as well be high howler anyway. So that was 100% wolf and 110% stupid! The animation's too bouncy, the art direction's bizarre, and not in a good way. Our protagonists are annoying or just plain embarrassing. The villains are absolutely justified in everything they do. Everybody is stupid beyond belief. The story's a mess. The world building was a complete joke. And the whole thing about, all that matters is your big heart, is just pandering, insulting bullshit. Yes, love is clearly a factor in any family unit, but this is a movie about werewolves! We want to see werewolves, not were-care bears! It doesn't matter that we're still a few weeks away from Halloween. I'm giving the box a little treat.
We're gonna die young.
Hey guys, I've got a package here to open from Ms. Maracruz Covarrubias from Rockport, Texas. I apologize if I mispronounced your name there. Let's see what we got here. Oops. Oh my goodness, we have got what looks like a love note to you and me, baby. Let's see what we got inside. Thank you, little love ravens.
Oh, that's cute.
Hi, Bob, Sean, and Raven. How are you two doing? Is Raven's mom okay? I'm awful.
Yes, proof that he waits way too long to open his fan mail.
I'm sorry, Raven's mom. I'm terrible. My name is Maracruz Covarrubias. I'm 42 years old. I live with my dad and uncle in Rockport, Texas. I have two dogs and a cat. Hello, two dogs and a cat and the extended family. My favorite cartoons are Casper's Scare School, My Little Pony, and Gravity Falls. My favorite movies are Carrie, Love at First Bite, Little Shop of Horrors, love that, Rockula, and Hairspray. My favorite TV shows are Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Match Game, The Gong Show, Fresh Off the Boat, and...
I love The Gong Show!
Never saw it. I'm going to have to take a peek at that. Aunt Mom. I have three sacrifices to the box.
Ooh.
Bratz, Desert Jewels. Chihuahua, the movie.
Sounds awful.
Oh, no.
Oh, what?
An imitation to the Disney Chihuahua movie. Oh, God.
Off of Beverly Hills Chihuahua?
Yes. I'm sorry. It clearly says Chihuahua the movie here, but my mind just immediately leaps to Beverly Hills Chihuahua. Oh my God, they ripped that off? Oh. And Gabby and friends, it's a happy day. Oh dear.
happy day.
Yes, there's a reason why Max Fleischer Studios did not survive. little tip, if you get the Parrotville Post Office... if you get to the Parrotville post office, if lip movement and audio go out of sync, pause it for about 10 seconds and play again. Hope you get this package okay. Sincerely, Mari.
Hello, motorcycle.
Yes, hello, motorcycle. Please be quiet. We're rolling here. I gotta put up a big red beacon outside of my window that says, recording. Quiet, please. But thank you very much for that. And let us delve into the contents within. Very carefully wrapped because we don't want to damage these precious gems.
Hey, that's box fodder.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yep, we have got a collection of Gabby cartoons. And
well, we say it's box fodder. It might be surprisingly good. It's probably not good. But it might be surprisingly good. You have to go into it with an open... Oh, my God.
Yeah. I'm saying nothing, just showing off the pink DVD case that I've got for Chihuahua the movie.
Chihuahua the movie that's been dipped in Pepto-Bismol.
A must-see for fans of Beverly Hills Chihuahua and Big. So, you know, it says right there on the DVD info.
Oh, they're just owning it.
Yep. There's no shame here. Yeah, we're ripping up Beverly Hills Chihuahua. What? Sandra Wellington, Anya Button, is bossy, controlling, and extremely unpleasant. Oh, so Chihuahua.
I think that's the Chihuahua's person?
Ah, gotcha.
Maybe?
But everything changes when a special friend from Sandra's past transforms her into Bella, her assistant's lovable little Chihuahua. Nope, she is the Chihuahua. Kind of, okay. Sort of.
She is transformed into the Chihuahua to make her a better person.
There seems to be some holes in that process.
And I never watched Beverly Hills Chihuahua, so I don't know if... Is that the plot of it?
Doubtful. In order to gain access... Oh, sorry, I missed a sentence here. While Sandra lives as Bella, her real body is in a coma. In order to gain access to the hospital, Sandra must prove that she has what it takes to be a therapy dog. As she learns the tricks of the trade, she becomes more connected with the people around her and realizes her past mistakes. It appears that Sandra is finally ready to turn over a new leaf in her own life. That is, if she ever gets the chance. Well, gee, thanks for the spoilers.
Chihuahuas can't be therapy dogs. Chihuahuas are need therapy dogs.
Yes.
Yes. They're neurotic.
I'm therapeutic!
Yeah, how emotionally supportive is that thing?
Oh, Lord. And the final DVD here is Bratz Desert Jewel. And oh, goodness.
I thought you said rats when you read the letter.
Oh, no, Bratz. Bratz. Sorry if I said rats. I'm pretty sure I said Bratz, but yes, Bratz Desert Jewel, where they're apparently ripping off Aladdin in this. So, you know, fun.
Who else wants to see all of the Bratz movies remade with anthropomorphic rats?
No, because you have to make the rats cartoonishly sexy, too, and it's going to be all kinds of awkward. By the way, before we're shooting this video, I should point out that that while Raven and I were having lunch, we saw a little bit of Bad Boys 2. I'm not going to explain what the connection is. What?
We have to watch it in small pieces. I love Martin Lawrence. I love Will Smith. My God, Michael Bay has crapped all over them.
And the rat species as a whole. I'm not going to explain it, but those of you who have seen the movie know what I'm talking about. Anyway, join the Bratz in this magical quest filled with mystery, friendship, and of course, fashion!
Oh my God!
Yasmin, Chloe, Sasha, and Jade travel to a far-off exotic land with their friend Kesha for a one-of-a-kind adventure full of fashion and ancient myths. What?
It's Kesha.
Kesha. It's K-A-T-I-A. I can only assume I'm pronouncing that correctly. Or it's Katia. I don't know.
Katia? Katia?
I'm just chewing my gum here. When the girls are whisked away on a magic carpet during a fashion show, they find themselves on an unexpected quest to discover an enchanted genie lamp. But will they find this mystical treasure before it falls into evil hands? Along the way, the girls make a new friend, Alia.
Alia?
Really?
Aliyoop? Oh, I just had an epiphany.
What's that?
Bratz Month.
Ah! No, the special effects there would be too severe. I would have to give myself a giant head throughout the entire proceedings.
Make him do it, guys!
No! No!
Bratz Month! Bratz Month! Bratz Month! Bratz Month!
I hate you so very, very much.
I know!
Let's see, anyway. Along the way, the girls make a new friend, Alia, and help her discover the richest treasure of all.
Or maybe
friendship!
Alia? Friendship is magic.
You shut your mouth.
And Little Pony Month, too.
No.
Oh, yeah.
We already did that with the Christmas and the fan films. I'm sorry. If you want to make a line of toys selling friendship as well as fashion, okay, fine. Why call it Bratz if friendship is key? Do you want to sell Bratz ship as a good thing? I don't think you do. But as wildly popular as they are, I guess it worked. So, hooray for being a brat. Oh, dear. But thank you, Mayor Cruz. I'm sure that the box will be very pleased with these special gifts.
Oh, yes. So many ideas.
Oh, you've already got something percolating, don't you?
Bratz Mom.
Oh, why do you people do this to me?
Because your pain is entertaining. Established it.
I know.
The more you hurt, the funnier you are.
You just want to watch me bleed. I'm terrible. But thank you so
much. Could do the entire month in Valley Girl.
What? No. I'm not gonna do it.
He's already warming to the idea, I can tell.
Edward wasn't enough. I gotta go in drag again. Long, pretty blonde hair.
He reaches $1,000 a month on his Patreon. He's going to review Rocky Horror Picture Show as drag show.
Oh, yeah. That's coming. Maybe.
Oh, my God. I can't wait. He's make it 50
make
right
it now. And make it happen, people. You know you want to. So yes, again, thank you for this lovely package. My box is going to be very pleased. Wow, that came out filthy. And anyone who wants to send me movies to review or comics, fan mail or whatever, just go ahead and ship it to the P.O. Box in the corner. And we will see you guys later.
Bye.
Subscribe.